Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the dawn on Easter Sunday morning here in Helen's Bay. There's been a tradition for a good number of years now. Four churches in the area gather together on the beach as the sun rises over the bay as a reminder, a very simple symbol of the Sun of Righteousness rising on our lives and on the whole of humanity. Obviously, this service today was recorded a little earlier in the week, but we did all get out of bed, so we'll be here for all dawn. It's simple, it's beautiful. I hope something of this sunrise will inspire your life and your living. Somehow we will be not just celebrating the resurrection, but celebrating moving out of the pandemic, moving into normality, into a life where we will truly touch God. God bless, and have the rest of it.
Very good morning to you. We are delighted to be able to be together, albeit online, this Easter season, to begin our dawn service with the joint churches. Let me pray as we begin. Heavenly Father, you are gracious and steady, the presence that we need always. You are the maker of the universe, the creator of all life, and the sustainer of your people. Father, your track record of loving kindness is well proven. There is no love like yours. Father, these are the qualities we need and praise you for this Easter. From the pain and anguish of Good Friday, to the deep, quiet reflections of Silent Saturday, to this joyful and brightening morning, we need your guiding hand and heart. Indeed, not only for this week, but for our lives. We've had a year of pain and anguish. We have been forced towards deeper reflection, and we now look forward to brighter, better days. Only you can guide us and provide for us. And provide you have in abundance in the Lord Jesus. His death was unimaginable, but the victory and peace he won more so. We continue to wrestle with such lavish grace. Our hearts tend towards guilt and the works of human hands. Father, send us instead to the finished work of Jesus, completed on this Easter Sunday. We cannot add to that perfection, so help us to rest in it, forsaking our feelings and human efforts, and instead chasing more faith and more grace. We come near to you because you have come near to us. Refresh your spirit within your church as we emerge from our own darkness of lockdown, fear and worry. Enliven us to live in the light and to long that that light bear on others. Father, we pray for a moment in our community and in our land, a moment of renewal of hearts that are drawn to your Son. Renew us, remake us, so that we might prove ourselves trustworthy with the revival we long for. As we cannot hold back the rising of the sun, we cannot hold back your Son, his glorious resurrection and his kingdom rule of all the light touches. He is risen, risen indeed. May we rise to his calling and always in his name. Amen.
On Easter Sunday morning, we read the gospel story from Mark chapter 16, verses 1 to 8. Let us hear God's word. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go to anoint the body of Jesus. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter, he is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. Amen. And we thank God for his word.
Let's pray. Our great God, would you come by the power of your Holy Spirit and speak to us today? Amen. I wonder if you have ever been to a funeral where you've been so bowed down with grief that the next day you decide to go back just to make sure, because it just seems so unreal. These two ladies, they returned with a reason to anoint the body. There is an urgency, there is an expectancy. They'd seen the tomb where his body was laid after he was taken down from the cross, yet they had to return home where they prepared the spices and ointments. But their work was delayed because of the Sabbath. Even though Nicodemus and Joseph had anointed their Lord's body, it was done in haste. And so these ladies want to complete what the men had to hurry to do. We read how it's early in the morning, it's still dark. They left their homes, meet together and head to the tomb of Jesus. Their task is urgent and it's one of devotion and worship. They loved him and courageously, they don't fear the darkness nor being identified with Jesus. As they journey to the tomb, they wondered how they will roll the stone away, and on arrival they expect to see, to find Jesus' body. They do not expect to enter the tomb and find it empty. Verse 6. As they enter the tomb, they don't see Jesus, but a young man dressed in white sitting on the right side, and they are alarmed. I suspect they're more than alarmed. Angry, distressed, disappointed, and heartbroken. But then he speaks and he says this: "Do not be alarmed. You're looking for Jesus of Nazareth who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." Do you hear it again? This urgency, this need to get the information out there. Just come on, he's saying to them. He's saying, he is risen from the dead. I love the fact that Peter is mentioned. It's already a bringing him back into the group after his disclosure of not knowing Jesus. You see, Jesus knows him, and he knows you too. In this moment, the ladies not only enter the tomb, but they enter back into life with Jesus, who is alive. They entered a tomb expecting death, and they discover life, and so they depart excited. Excitement isn't how we normally feel when we leave a graveside. Yet these ladies are euphoric because of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Mark records that they left quickly and fled, and that they trembled and were amazed. If we are followers of Jesus, we must have an urgency and an expectancy in sharing the good news of Jesus. So how do we respond to hearing this story this year? I want to encourage us to be 5E Christians. Now, not 5G, 5E. Early in activity, expectant for God, entering into worship, enabled and empowered by the Holy Spirit, and excited about sharing our faith. The ladies went early. Let's be early and urgent to come to faith and to live out our faith, to share our faith with others. The ladies are expectant. Let's expect God to do the unexpected in our lives and the lives of our community, those who live within our community, our family, our friends. Let's expect God to transform lives. The ladies entered into the tomb. They took a risk. Whilst they were alarmed, they entered into dialogue with an unknown man and discovered this is not the end of the story as they had feared, but actually, really the beginning. The new normal, if you like. Let's enter into risk taking for the sake of the kingdom of God. The ladies are now excited to share this amazing news. The resurrection of the Lord allows us a different view of death. Death is no longer a dead end. It is no longer something that one must face with dread and despair. Death is no longer the enemy of those who trust in Jesus, because it has been challenged and conquered by Jesus. And so the ladies' job is to go tell all the disciples and Peter. I love that. It implies Peter may not be with the others, but he has not been forgotten. The one who maybe has failed in friendship, in this case failed a failing friend, is being brought back in. And this news is to be shared urgently. I don't know whether you know the old gospel hymn, and it goes like this. I'm not going to sing it this morning for you. God sent his son, they called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he lives. And because Jesus lives, Peter will be reinstated. Because he lives, because Jesus lives, we can receive forgiveness of sins. We too can live even when we die. For those of us who have put our trust in Jesus as Savior and Lord, those who recognize our need of our sins forgiven and who turn around from a life without care or thought, who repent, who turn around from that life of without care or thought of God. You see, the passion of Christ and his death would have been without merit without the resurrection. The devil thought he had won. Jesus had died on the cross, his limp, lifeless body removed from the cross and laid in a tomb, secure, sealed, and guarded by Roman soldiers. Yet death and the grave cannot hold the sinless Son of God, he who had authority to lay down his life and the authority to take it up again. And so this Easter morning in 2021, let's determine to be 5E Christians. Let's be early in activity to build the kingdom of God and to rebuild community in this post-COVID, as lockdown ends, era. Let's be expecting God to reveal his power to us, expecting to be guided by the power of the Holy Spirit. Let's enter into worship as we return to in-church worship. Let's invite others to come too. Let's enable and empower, let's be enabled and empowered to live in the power of God's Holy Spirit. The same power that raised Jesus from the grave is available to all followers of Jesus. And let's be excited to see that God's kingdom grow. Let's be excited to see God's kingdom grow as we invite everyone we know to meet the risen Lord Jesus, the Savior of the world. In this era in history, I believe the Church of Jesus Christ, whatever congregation you belong to, there must and we must have an urgency and a boldness like never before. Urgency to go and share the good news that he is risen, and an expectancy to keep bringing to life the teachings of Jesus Christ and what God can do. He is risen. Alleluia. Happy Easter.
Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you. Gladden your hearts and scatter the darkness from before you. Blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and with those whom you love this Easter morning and throughout the year of rising. Amen.
Embrace, for I am yours. fail and fear surround.